Hey guys, welcome back. So today we're going to be looking at point of inflection. We're going to be looking at how to find them, how to determine them, and then also how to sketch them. If you haven't watched the video on me doing stationary points and determining their nature, make sure you watch that first. But with that said, let's get into it. Okay, so this question says find the point of inflection of this function here. Now, what's a point of inflection? Now, a point of inflection is basically when the graph, or when your curve, changes concavity. So kind of like a cubic, think of a cubic like this. It goes from concave, think of a cubic like this, right? It goes from concave up, okay? Because this bit would be concave up. And then at some point it turns around and then becomes concave down. Now that point there is what we call our point of inflection. So when the concavity changes. Now to show this using algebra and calculus, we're basically finding when does the second derivative equal zero. Now, you remember from the last video, the first derivative gives us the gradient, okay, or the gradient function, whereas the second derivative gives us the concavity. So, let's do that. Okay, so finding the first derivative will be 3x squared minus 12x plus 5. Do it again, so differentiate again. That's 6x minus 12. And now we need to solve for this equal to zero to find any points of inflection. So 6x minus 12 equals zero. So x is equal to 2. Now, what we need to do is we need to test whether or not this is actually a point of inflection. So we do this similar to the previous video where we did a table and we put x and then f dash. But for this one, we're going to do f double dash. We'll stick 2 in the middle and we'll just choose a number on either side. So 3 and 1. And what we want to know is whether or not left of 2 is concave up or right of 2 is concave down. So here, I'll just put a zero here, okay? Now, what is f double dash of 1? Okay, well, f double dash of 1 is 6 times 1 minus 12. That's going to be 6 minus 12, so that's minus 6. Put that here. F double dash of 3 is going to be 6 times 3 minus 12. That's 18 minus 12. That's 6. So when the number here is negative, that means it is concave down. Okay, so let me put a little concave down parabola. When it's flat, it's nothing, okay? And then when it's 6, it is concave up. So when it's greater than 0, it's concave up. Now you see here that on either side of the number 2, our concavity changes. So therefore, this point is a point of inflection. Now, one more thing we need to know. We just need to know what is the y coordinate. What is the corresponding y coordinate when x is equal to 2? So what I need to do is put this one back into there. Okay, so what is the f of 2? Well, that's going to be 2 cubed minus 6 times 2 squared plus 5 times 2 plus 1. That's 8 minus 6 times 4 is 24 plus 10 plus 1. 8 minus 24 is minus 16 plus 11. So your y coordinate will be 5. So therefore, 2, negative 5 is a point of inflection. Done. Okay, question 6 says, show that x to the power of 6 doesn't have a point of inflection. All right, so let's do that. So f of x is equal to x to the 6. I'm getting ahead of myself. F of x is equal to 6x to the 5. And then f double dash x is equal to 30x to the 4. Okay. Now, we're solving for the second derivative is equal to 0. So 30x to the 4 equals 0. So x is equal to 0. Okay? Now, we want to put that number into our table. So x, f double dash of x. We'll put the 0 in the middle. Choose a number on either side. Okay, so when x is equal to minus 1, what is f double dash x? So f double dash of minus 1 will be 30, negative 1 to the power of 4. Minus 1 to an even power is going to be positive, so it's going to be 30. And then f double dash of 1, well, that's going to be the same, isn't it? Okay, which is also 30. Now look what happens here. So we notice that 30 is greater than 0, so that's concave up. 30 is also greater than 0, so it's also concave up on the right-hand side. So because there is no change in concavity, this is not a point of inflection. Okay, so therefore, x equals 0 is not a point of inflection because the concavity does not change. Now, if you're just curious what this looks like, x to the power of 6 will look something like this. Oh, it will look more flat, actually. It'll look more like this. Okay, x to the power of 6. And you can put this in the Desmos to have a look. But it's kind of similar to a parabola, just more flat at the bottom. But as you can see, it does not change concavity. Okay, so we finally reached the question where we need to sketch, and we need to include stationary points and also points of inflection. Okay, so first of all, let's find our stationary points. And that's when f dash x is equal to 0. So f dash x will be minus 3 plus 3x squared. So minus 3 plus 3x squared equals 0. 3x squared is equal to 3. X squared is equal to 1. So x is equal to plus and minus 1. Okay? Now, right now, I'll just quickly find the corresponding y value. So f of minus 1, that's going to be 1 minus 3 times negative 1 plus negative 1 cubed. So that's 1 plus 3 minus 1, I think. So that should be 3. And then f of 1 will be 1 minus 3 times 1 plus 1 cubed. So what's that? 1 minus 3 plus 1. So 1 minus 3 plus 1, so that's minus 2 plus 1, so that's minus 1. So my coordinates will be minus 1 and 3 and 1 and negative 1. Okay, now to determine the nature. So I've whipped up a table. I'm going to put in my coordinates of minus 1 here and 1. And I'm just going to stick numbers in between. So let's say minus 2, 0, and 2. These obviously got a gradient of 0. So what is the gradient at x is equal to negative 2? So I need to substitute it into here. So f dash of negative 2, that's minus 3 plus 3 of minus 2 squared. Minus 3 plus 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 3 is 12. So this will be 9. Okay, f dash of 0, well, that's going to be minus 3 plus 3 times 0 squared. So that's negative 3. That's easy. And then f dash of 2 will be minus 3 plus 3 of 2 squared. So I think that's going to be the same as the other one. So minus 3 plus 12 equals 9. Done. Okay, so now I just want to put in the gradient so I can see if it's a min or a max. So it's positive, flat, negative. That's going to be a max, and then flat, and then this one is positive. So straight away I can tell that that's going to be a max. Okay, and then this one's going to be a min. So let me just write that below. This is a max, and this is a min. Okay, so we've got the stationary points done. Now we need to find the points of inflection. Okay, so for remember, the point of inflection, we need to find the second derivative is equal to 0. Okay, so the first derivative is f dash x is minus 3 plus 3x squared. So the second derivative will be 6x. Okay, now let's solve this equal to 0. So 6x equals 0. So x is equal to 0. So x could be a point of inflection, but remember, we need to test. So what is the corresponding y value? So what is the original? What's f of 0? Just to find what's the coordinate that goes with that. So I go back up here, and my function is 1 minus 3x plus x cubed. So it's 1 minus 3 times 0 plus 0 cubed. So that's going to be 1. Okay? So my coordinate here is going to be 0, 1. All right, now I need to test and see if the concavity changes. Okay, so I stick 0 in the middle, we'll put minus 1 on either side, and then 1 on the other side. This is obviously 0. So f double dash of minus 1, what's that? That's 6 times negative 1, so that's negative 6. And then f double dash of 1, well, that's going to be just 6. Okay, so you can see that the concavity does, in fact, change. So therefore, this is a point of inflection. All right, now let's sketch it. Okay, so let's put in some of these points. Well, first of all, I always like to start with a y-intercept. The y-intercept is when x equals 0, so that'll be 0, that'll be 0. So y-intercept will be 1. So I'll put 1 here. Now, I know I've got a stationary point at minus 1, 3, and that's a max. So let's go minus 1 here and 3 up here. So this point here is a max, and I'll do a little upside down U to show that. And I've also got 1 minus 1, which is a min. So once again, I'll do a min shape just to show that and remind myself. And this point of inflection is at 0, 1. Well, what do you know? The 0, 1 is also the y-intercept. So it's going to change concavity at this point here. Now, if I just do a rough outline just to show you, it's going to do something like this. Okay, so as you can see, it's concave down up until this point, and then it becomes concave up from the y-intercept onwards. Okay, so we won't bother with what the x-intercepts are for these graphs. We're just illustrating how to find the point of inflection and also the stationary points. All right, that's it for today. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. If you want to see more videos like this or videos on other topics, let me know. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.